An elementary school student is leaving the hospital after a meningitis scare.
This student goes to Dibble Elementary, and right now the district is cleaning the school. They are taking precautions. Eyewitness News 5's Mark Opgren found out how they plan on keeping students safe, and it's new at 5.
The Dibble School District sent out a letter to students and parents this afternoon. It says that the student who had meningitis most likely had the viral kind. It was business as usual at Dibble Schools today, 3 days after a first grader came down with meningitis.
At first I didn't know what it was, and then kind of found out about it.
Immediately, janitors cleaned the elementary school, focusing on areas most students congregate, like hallways, bathrooms, and water fountains. They also notified parents. Today, the district learned the student probably has viral meningitis, which is less severe than bacterial infection.
It's a big relief. You know, first of all, it's a relief that it looks as if this child's going to be okay, and then that, you know, some of the tensions and the worry of our community could ease maybe a bit.
But at least one parent believes they should have done more.
I think they should have shut the school down until they cleaned the whole school. It didn't mean just a grade school, it meant the whole school.
Until they know for sure what kind of meningitis the student has, the district says they will continue to update parents and clean the school thoroughly.
The district also says they have no reason to believe that anybody else at the school contracted meningitis, but they are still taking many precautions. In Dibble, Mark Opgren, Eyewitness News 5.
Now, when the tests come back, the district says it will let parents know what type of meningitis that student had. You know, there have been other cases of meningitis in Oklahoma recently as well. An outbreak killed 2 children in Ooligah back in March. And a student at Traub Elementary School in Midwest City got sick with viral meningitis just last month.